Before I move on to another alignment series in a different part of the world, as I had planned for my next video, the subject of historic trolley parks came back up to the surface for me, leading me back into this subject for a much deeper investigation. My name is Michelle Gibson. I first learned about trolley parks doing research on Palisades Park for the Circle Alignments on the Planet Washington, D.C., Part 6, the Lower Hudson River in New York City and New Jersey. And I visited the subject of trolley parks towards the end of the incredible similarity of electric tram systems worldwide. Trolley parks were said to have started in the United States in the 19th century as picnic and recreation areas at the ends of streetcar lines and were precursors to amusement parks. By 1919, there were estimated to be between 1,500 and 2,000 such parks. For example, Luna Park at Coney Island in Brooklyn was a trolley park. The other day, one of my YouTube subscribers shared with me about the historic Exposition Park and the current amusement park there, Conneaut Lake Park, in her hometown of Conneaut Lake in northwestern Pennsylvania, not far from Lake Erie. The town was founded in 1799 as Evansburg and was renamed Conneaut Lake in 1892. The same year that the Exposition Park there opened. The Exposition Park was founded by Colonel Frank Mantor, owner of the Conneaut Lake Exposition Company, with the stated purpose of being a permanent fairground and exposition for livestock, machinery, and industrial products. There are two definitions of the word exposition. One is a device used to give background information to the audience about the setting and characters of the story. Exposition is used in television programs, movies, literature, plays, and even music. What better way to tell your audience the story you want them to believe than the other definition of exposition, a large exhibition of art or trade goods? There was a dance hall there. A bowling alley, and docks and a boat pavilion. Ownership of the park transferred to the railroad in 1901, and in 1907, trolley service was said to have been extended to the park. This picture depicts the trolley station at Exposition Park at Conneaut Lake. Many of the park's original buildings were lost in a fire in 1908. This photo was said to have been taken the day after the fire. The hotel cannot remain standing in the background. But nothing remained of the park's midway. While arson was suspected as a cause of the fire at the time, it was never proven. One more thing. When I was researching the town of Conneaut Lake, I found out that the Beaver and Erie Canal was there, along with the railroad. Construction of the Beaver and Erie Canal was said to have started in 1831, completed in 1844, and closed in 1872. So they are telling us it took 13 years to build, and then only used for 28 years? Right. They don't give us a construction date for the Pittsburgh and Lake Erie Railroad, just that it was formed in 1875. There is also an exposition park in the south part of Los Angeles that was started, we are told, in 1872 as an agricultural fairground. By 1879, the original owner was foreclosed on because it wasn't making enough money. New owners of agricultural park were said to have brought in a racetrack, and the trolley line arrived in 1875. In 1908, the state of California acquired Agricultural Park and worked on transforming the park. It reopened as Exposition Park in 1913. This is a 1942 postcard. The Los Angeles Memorial Coliseum is an exposition park, with its construction said to have been commissioned in 1921 as a memorial to Los Angeles veterans of World War I. It seems very strange to me to find two headless bodies greeting the people who come to this stadium. What's up with that? It is right across the street from the University of Southern California, also known as USC. This building on the top is on the campus of USC, which was established in 1880, and pictured beneath it is the Midland Bank Building on Ludgate Hill in London, said to have been built in 1891. This is the Natural History Museum of Los Angeles County in Exposition Park. This huge classical domed building was said to have been established in 1913, the same year the former agricultural park became known as Exposition Park. There is much more here, including the Metro Expo Line light rail, but this gives you the idea. This is incredibly sophisticated architecture and infrastructure for it to have been built during the time frame to which it is attributed to in our historical narrative. The oldest continually operating amusement park in the United States is Lake Compounce in Bristol, Connecticut, said to have been open every summer since 1846. The history of Lake Compounce is traced back to 1846. This is the year when Gad Norton opened the area to the public. He tried a publicity stunt of hiring a scientist to perform experiments, including with explosives. The large crowd he attracted was said to motivate him to develop the area into a small park, including picnic tables. This is the only picture I could find associated with his name, his grave marker in Bristol, Connecticut. He was said to have joined forces in 1851 with Isaac Pierce, who had fared well in the California Gold Rush of 1849, and over the next few decades, the park was said to meet with mild success. In 1895, we are told a trolley line connected Lake Compounce to an emerging network of inexpensive public transportation. Amusement parks like Lake Compounce created an escape from reality, with early competitive opportunities like baby shows, entertainment for the masses, and thrilling rides like the Green Dragon, the park's first electric roller coaster. In Kansas City, Electric Park was the name of two amusement parks said to have been built by the Heim brothers, Joseph Ferdinand Jr. and Michael. As brewers, they followed in the footsteps of their father, Ferdinand Sr. He was said to have come to the United States from Austria in 1854, and he started brewery operations in Manchester, Missouri between 1857 and 1862, and in East St. Louis, Illinois, from 1870 to 1879. Father and sons jointly purchased the Star Ale Brewery of the East Bottoms in Kansas City in 1884. The first electric park was said to have been built right next to the brewery in the East Bottoms after the Heim brothers built a streetcar line to it, and they wanted a way to attract visitors to the streetcar line and to the brewery. Open from 1899 to 1906, the first electric park was an immediate success as one of the world's first full-time amusement parks. Among other things, beer was piped directly from the brewery to the beer garden at the park. So here you have escape from reality, plus strong German lager. Soon the success of Kansas City's electric park, we are told, necessitated a larger location. So the second electric park opened in 1907. Also on a trolley line, it was said to be the largest to be called electric park in the United States. It opened in 1907. Souvenirs from the park, like this one from 1913, touted it as Kansas City's Coney Island. Most of this grand park, which was said to have inspired young Walt Disney to build his own version of it, burned to the ground in 1925. The Electric Park in Detroit, Michigan, was in operation between 1906 and 1928. It was located on East Jefferson Drive in Detroit, adjacent to the bridge to Belle Isle. Originally a trolley park, the Electric Park in Detroit was at the end of three trolley lines, but we are told public transportation shifted to buses by the 1920s, as trolleys were already becoming obsolete. The 1920s saw legal battles not only over the ownership of the park, but also challenging its existence. In 1927, the city of Detroit condemned many of the park's structures as a blight, closing the park permanently. Detroit's Electric Park was leveled the following year and became a new public park. At one time, there was an electric park in the Hudson River Valley on Kinderhook Lake at the town of Niverville, New York. It was described by some as the largest amusement park on the East Coast between Manhattan and Montreal during its run from 1901 to 1917. We are told this electric park was created by the Albany and Hudson Railroad Company in order to increase ridership on weekends. A round-trip trolley ride, admission to the park, and a seat at the vaudeville show at Rustic Theater cost 40 cents. One of the rides at the park was called Shooting the Chutes, while it is called a precursor to today's water flume rides. It looks a lot like an inclined plane gravity railroad to me, like the Granite Railway in Quincy, Massachusetts, said to have been built in 1826, and reminds me of the inclined planes found on sections of the Morris Canal in New Jersey. The reasons given for the closing of the electric park in Niverville in 1917 was that the popularity of automobiles no longer restricted people to rails and river steamer transportation, World War I, and high insurance premiums due to the number of trolley parks that had burned down. I found this list of over 30 more electric parks alone, all over the United States. They were constructed as trolley parks and were owned primarily by electric companies and streetcar companies. This does not come even close to listing all of the trolley parks in the United States at one time. There are many more examples along the same lines to which I will give you just a simple introduction. First are some examples of parks that got their start as trolley parks and are still operating today. Camden Park in Huntingdon, West Virginia, originally a picnic spot, turned into an amusement park by the Camden Interstate Railway Company in 1903. Canobie Lake Park in Salem, New Hampshire, since 1902. Lakeside Amusement Park in Denver, Colorado, operating since 1908. Waldemere Park in Erie, Pennsylvania, since 1896. And Conneaut Lake Park still operates as an amusement park, where the exposition park that I started this video with was located. Next are trolley parks that are no more. Luna Park at Coney Island opened in 1903, mostly destroyed by fire in 1944, and demolished in 1946. Luna Park in Arlington, Virginia, opened in 1906 and closed in 1915 due to a fire. Luna Park in Seattle, Washington, which operated from 1907 to 1913, closing, we are told, due to problems arising from things like lawsuits from injuries on rides and management disputes. Luna Park in Charleston, West Virginia, opened to the public between 1912 and 1923, and closed after a fire destroyed the roller coaster there. Luna Park in Cleveland, Ohio, in operation between 1905 and 1929, closing due to problems with fires and financial solvency with the advent of the Great Depression. Luna Park in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, operated from 1905 to 1909, closing due to high costs and competition from a second park in Pittsburgh. Called Kennywood Park, which is still in existence today, and founded in 1898 as a trolley park. Luna Park in Scranton, Pennsylvania, operating from 1906 to 1916. Council Crest Amusement Park in Portland, Oregon, operating as a trolley park from 1907 to 1929, also said to have closed due to financial insolvency with the beginning of the Great Depression. Dixieland Amusement Park in Jacksonville, Florida, operating from 1907 to 1917, closing with the entry of the United States into World War I. Big Island Amusement Park on Lake Minnetonka's Big Island in Minneapolis, Minnesota, operating between 1906 and 1911, closing due to excessive operating costs and lack of revenue in the off-season. Glen Echo Park in Glen Echo, Maryland, operating between 1921 and 1968, with this photo being taken in 1939. And Wonderland Amusement Park in Indianapolis, Indiana, operating between 1906 and 1911, the year it burned down. I am quite certain that the historic amusement park infrastructure I have shared with you in this video was built by the advanced ancient worldwide Moorish civilization, and was also at one time part of a sophisticated free energy generation and distribution system. Something happened recently to knock humanity off of this original positive timeline, and I've gone into detail on what I have been able to put together to provide an explanation for what has taken place based on my research in my video, An Explanation for What Happened to the Positive Timeline of Humanity and Associated Historical Events and Anomalies. And in my take on the mud flood and historical reset timeline. This beautiful and balanced Moorish civilization was a continuous civilization from Mu and Atlantis up until the time the hijack of the timeline occurred. It was removed from the collective awareness and replaced with a false historical narrative to explain what is in the environment around us and keep us from knowing the true history of humanity and the fullest expression of its potential. The beings behind the hijack of the original timeline, one, based much in the new historical narrative on the Moorish legacy, but twisted and subverted from its positive original meaning and or teaching. And two, destroyed, repurposed, and or discontinued the use of countless types of the original Moorish infrastructure, as seen in the examples of most of America's trolley parks that are long gone. Where did all the trolleys go? In my next video, I will be looking at an interesting alignment I found off of San Francisco. Unless something else interesting like this comes up,